In this video, I'll talk about threads and threading. Think of threads like workers. Each worker can only do one job at the same time. If you need more work to be done at the same time, you need more workers. It's the same for programming. Each script is a different thread, and there can also be multiple threads on the same script. Here, I have some lines of code which doesn't really make sense, but it's all for showcasing threading. If we think that the entire script is a thread, and it can only do one job at a time, then it shouldn't go below while loop. It will connect the event, and then it will print that statement every 1 second. Its job is unlimited at this point, so it won't progress. However, once this event connects, it will be able to print once player touches the part. As you can guess from now on, because it runs at a different thread, we can test it with running the game. As you can see, none of the prints below the while loop actually printed to the output. Because the thread is stuck here, none of the code below will run. If having the loop here is necessary, we can just run it in a different thread. I'll use one of the methods of creating a new thread. There are other ones, but most of them will have their separate video. We can quickly test for new results. As you can see from the output, every single of them printed. A lot of the threads here are unnecessary, but I did it just for showcasing them. These methods do almost the same thing, but there are some major differences which is worth separate videos for each one of them. I want to go over errors now. If you make a syntax error in a thread, script won't run after that. There's nothing in the output with the error, but for other errors, it's a bit different. If a thread errors, it will not affect other threads. In this script there is an error. Something named part 1 doesn't exist in workspace, so it will error. And as you can see from the output, one thread has an error, but prints still continue. However, if a thread errors, that thread won't be able to run more lines, and it will be a dead thread. For the end of the video, I want to talk about performance. Having more threads will mean there are a lot of workers, which also affects performance. You shouldn't create threads unless you need to. Examples shown in this video are mostly for showcasing only. That was it for this video. Hope you understood. See you in another one.